Today, Hurricane Ian tied for the title of fifth strongest hurricane to ever hit the United States. It also tied with 2004's Hurricane Charley as the second strongest hurricane to ever make landfall on the west coast of Florida. The two hurricanes even made landfall in near identical spots right next to Punta Gorda and Port Charlotte. But that tie and comparisons between Hurricanes Charley and Ian are misleading. Here's Hurricane Ian as seen from space. The whole storm is 500 miles wide. But when we talk about a hurricane, the part we are typically most concerned about is the section of the storm with hurricane force winds. The yellow and red here that stretches from Tampa to Naples. Those winds are more than 100 miles wide. The eye of the storm alone is more than 30 miles wide. Just gigantic. And for comparison, here is how wide the hurricane force winds were for Hurricane Charley. 10 miles wide. That whole hurricane could fit in the eye of today's storm. So yes, the storms are tied in wind strength, but Ian is going to hit way more of Florida and will likely do so much harder. Hurricane Charley had a maximum storm surge of 6 to 7 feet. Hurricane Ian is forecast for a maximum of 12 to 18 feet. Now that matters a ton because storm surge is likely to be the most deadly aspect of today's storm. Hurricane Ian is also moving much slower than Hurricane Charley, which means more time for rain to fall and, with that, more flooding. The reason I bring this up is not just to say that this hurricane is worse than its most comparable predecessor, but to talk about how hurricanes overall seem to be getting more extreme. There have only been 9 Category 3 or higher storms that have made landfall on Florida's west coast since the year 1950. 6 of those have been since the year 2000. It's impossible to tie any single weather event to climate change, but it is clearly the case that climate change is making storms like this one stronger. Joining us now is Katharine Hayhoe, chief scientist for the Nature Conservancy, professor at Texas Tech University, and author of Saving Us, a climate scientist's case for hope and healing in a divided world. Katharine, thank you so much for being with us tonight. I'd like to just get right to it, which is a lot of people are looking at what has been happening or not happening in Florida. And prior to this hurricane, we've actually had a fairly normal season in the U.S. this year, and there have only been a few named storms. So for people who are climate skeptics, how do you explain the role of climate change in a year like this?
The way I explain it is like this. We know that hurricanes are a natural phenomena, but climate change is exacerbating them, making them worse, like putting them on steroids. We aren't seeing a change in the overall number of hurricanes. But when those hurricanes happen, they are intensifying faster. They're getting stronger. They're dumping a lot more rain on us, and they're even moving more slowly. Climate change is truly loading the weather dice against us, putting us all at risk.
Can you explain why the intensification happened so rapidly, right? Ian was Category 3 last night, and then just over the course of a few hours this morning became a Category 4 and almost a Category 5. How do you attribute that to climate change?
That is something that we are seeing due to warmer oceans. So climate change is being caused primarily by digging up and burning coal and gas and oil, which produces heat-trapping gases that are building up in the atmosphere, wrapping an extra blanket around the planet. Now, over 90% of the extra heat that's being trapped by that blanket is going into the ocean, where it is powering stronger storms and enabling those storms to ratchet up far more quickly from a tropical storm to Category 1, 2, or even 3, 4, or 5.
The other piece of this that I think is really interesting is that, you know, scientific data shows that the hurricanes are increasingly moving slower than they were in the last century. How does that dovetail with climate change? Is that an effect of climate change? It certainly has deleterious effects once these large storm systems just hang out over land.
The data is showing that on average, storms are moving a bit more slowly, but the even more important factor that we haven't quite touched on yet is the fact that warmer air holds more water vapor. So when a storm comes along, as they always do, there's more water vapor for that storm to sweep up and dump on us today than there was 50 or 100 years ago. And although you mentioned that any given hurricane is not the result of climate change, we are able to put numbers on just how much worse climate change made a specific hurricane. With Hurricane Harvey, it's estimated that nearly 40% of the rain that fell during Harvey, and in some places it was over 50 inches of rain, would not have occurred if that same hurricane had happened 100 years ago, as it easily could have. It was estimated even worse that more areas flooded and more economic damages occurred, because you might be used to 20 inches or 30 inches and prepared for that, but once you get into the 40 and 50 inch range, that's where the really devastating economic damages occur. And that's where places get flooded that were not expecting it. So we can put very specific numbers today on how much worse climate change makes a heat wave, a wildfire, and a hurricane.
Putting numbers on it matters, because we can also assign economic damage to climate change, and that's the beginning of actual policy shift. Katharine Hayhoe, chief scientist for the Nature Conservancy and professor at Texas Tech University, thanks for your time and wisdom tonight.
Thank you for having me.